Well, it looks like a lot of news outlets don't really buy those numbers that Disney put out, where they proudly stated that 14 million views happened for Ahsoka, which nobody, well, some people that will just believe anything believe it, but most people were like, I'm not so sure that that's really accurate. And a lot of people just aren't buying it. Forbes put this out on the 29th. Ahsoka viewing numbers are well below The Mandalorian and Obi-Wan Kenobi, going by those Samba TV numbers. Then the other day, the Direct put new data reveals Ahsoka week viewership versus Star Wars other shows. People aren't buying those numbers that Disney put up. Why would they? What incentive do I have to believe Disney on anything? Of course they're going to come out and say that the show is a success. They're not going to actually release any data to show that. They're just going to say, yeah, 14 million views, whatever that means. Probably means multiple clicks, all kinds of stuff. The fact is, when you compare this show to previous Star Wars shows, it's in the dumpster. And that's not a good sign for Star Wars. Why would anybody be excited about Star Wars now? I mean, look at this. This was from Bounding Into Comics, came out yesterday. Who gets excited for this in a Star Wars book? After Star Wars killed Han Solo in The Force Awakens, they lectured him on racism in Star Wars Last Shot novel. Yeah, that's exactly what I want to hear about. That's exactly what I want to read about in a Star Wars story, sure. Like, this is not what Star Wars fans want. What they want are fun stories. Can you have allegories? Sure. There's a lot of that in even the original trilogy, but it was done in a way that worked and was fun, and that's why it's such a timeless trilogy. This new shit from Disney is going to age like milk. It already is aging like milk. And they've put so much of this garbage out that just people are checking out. They're checking out left and right. I think Star Wars is dead. I think video games and stuff like that will do okay for a while, as long as they're based in the original trilogy and kind of set in that area. Just like the recent, what was the name of the Star Wars game that's like Dark Souls? Jedi Survivor, Star Wars Jedi Survivor, and then there was Fallen Order. I played the first one. I didn't play the second one just because I just don't have time. I want to, and I will eventually. I liked that game more so because it was a Dark Souls clone, though, so I don't know if I would have enjoyed just a regular action game. Like, they have that, there's a open world Assassin's Creed type Star Wars game coming out. I don't care for that game. I probably will skip it completely because the trailer kind of turned me off to it, because there's once again just another struggling woman that's just trying to make her place in a galaxy of men like Ahsoka, which had the first lightsaber battle between women. Wow! Remember how excited the media was for that? Yeah, this franchise is dead. I don't even think you could repair it if you overhauled Lucasfilm and got all new people in there. I think the only way you could save Star Wars is to rest it for like 10 years and then bring it back. They've done so much damage to this franchise. It's just done. This show should have been a massive hit. Nobody's even really talking about it. I don't see, like, compare this to the Game of Thrones stuff that we had recently. That was really good. You look at that show and the way people were talking about it, and this show, it's very noticeable. I'm, of course, talking about House of the Dragon, by the way. I got the koof, so it's kind of messing with my head. I'm forgetting names of these shows. House of the Dragon is a great show. And you see that people were enjoying that by the way Everybody was talking about it. Just like everybody's talking about One Piece right now. But nobody's talking about Ahsoka. So, viewership data from Zomba TV revealed that 1.2 million households watched Ahsoka over the course of its first 6 days on Disney+, comparing that to The Book of Boba Fett, which had 1.9 million viewers in its first 6 days, and Obi-Wan Kenobi, which mustered up 2.14 million. As for The Mandalorian, the flagship show pulled in 2.08 million people in the first 4 days of the season two premiere, while season three only got 1.6 million within that same time frame. The new Zomba TV post also noted that Ahsoka's numbers were only slightly lower than Mandalorian season three's premiere when looked at over its first 6 days. It's important to note and point out that some of these metrics look at a different span of days. The Mandalorian and Obi-Wan are four, while Book of Boba Fett and Ahsoka are six. Oddly enough, Ahsoka TV did not cover Andor, so there aren't concrete numbers to pit directly against Ahsoka. That said, the original tweet revealing these new stats did mention that the viewership is similar to Andor's premiere season. And that's a sad fact. Andor, which I hear is great. Nobody watched it. That's another argument I think that you can put in there that Star Wars is dead. This is a dead brand. Marvel's quickly becoming a dead brand too. And it's funny. They try to come up with reasons why the viewership is so low. And they say, well, many will be quick to try and paint a bleak picture about Disney's Star Wars' latest series. There's one key difference between Ahsoka and the rest of the franchise's previous Disney Plus outings. None of those were dealing with two historic strikes in the entertainment industry. Them going out and promoting this show wouldn't really do much for it. Look at Obi-Wan, which had all of its star power out there doing promotion. Those numbers weren't that amazing either. You could have Rosario Dawson out there dancing and twirling with a sign every day in multiple locations and going viral, and I don't think it would help this show. Another thing I'd like to point out is the audience score for Ahsoka keeps getting lower every week. Every time they put out a new episode to this series, it gets a lower audience score. And now we're at the point to... I wonder how low it can go. Critics love it, of course. They love it. Except top critics who have... they're actually right there with the audience, which is kind of funny. Top critics hate everything. All critics, though, they love it. Fresh. It's a fresh, certified fresh show. Yeah, I don't know. I think Star Wars is dead. I love that none of these outlets are quoting Disney's stupid figure. Nobody's buying that bullshit. Except people that drive their cars alone with masks on. They do think that those numbers are legit. But everybody else is raising an eyebrow. Because while I'm sure, the thing with like Zomba and Nielsen is they're not accurate, true numbers. Like they're the best we're going to get through third party. What you can do is you can compare it to other shit. And when you compare it to other Star Wars shows, it's pretty clear that the numbers are dropping. Interest is waning. This franchise is done. And they have nobody to blame but themselves. They were literally handed a blueprint from George Lucas on how to make it great. They threw that in the trash, said they're going to do it better, and it blew up in their face. So, yeah, everything was riding on Ahsoka. This was the real test to where this franchise was, and we know now it's in the toilet. Anyway, let me know what you guys think about all this. I'd like to hear from you. Also, if you would, please like, subscribe, share the video. Make sure you're still subscribed. Hit that notification bell. Check out my Rumble and Locals. And I'll see you on the next one. Peace. Make sure to check out my Locals. There's a link in the description. It's a fun community that I'm trying to build over here. If you don't want to support me on YouTube, you can come over here. None of that money goes to YouTube. You also can just come over here for free. But if you are a supporter over here, I do plan on doing an extra live stream once a month and throwing links to the supporters
so you can actually come on and have a supporter live stream with me. Also, it's a good place to catch all of my content. You don't have to worry about notifications like YouTube. They'll definitely work over here. So come check out my locals.